Of the many popular outdoor activities that exist, hiking and spelunking can be very adventurous and rewarding. This hobby, of course, comes with many risks. Many caves are filled with dangerously high falls, falling objects, and then there's the risk of getting lost. In a previous video, I talked about a caver who encountered some strange occurrences on an expedition, but now we're going to take a look at a caver who wasn't lucky enough to return from his outing. Years ago, a YouTuber by the name of Snakebit McGee, real name Kenny, posted a comment on a video called "Son of an Area 51 Technician." The comments on this video have been disabled now, but at the time, it described him going on a hike near the Nellis Air Force Base in Nevada. During the hike, he found a cave shaped like a perfect capital M. As he approached the cave, his body began to vibrate. The closer he got to the cave, the more intense the vibrating became. Eventually, this feeling became too frightening, and he ran away from the cave. A lot of the responses he received were skeptical and demanded proof that this actually happened. He eventually responded saying he would go back again someday with a weapon and try to find the cave again. A few months later, he did as he promised and went back to the area to search for the cave. He even made a 20-minute long video documenting his search.
And I'm looking for a cave that I found, and something about that cave just spooked me. This one just made my body vibrate. The closer I got to it, the crazier my body felt.
Although he saw some interesting animals, he was not able to find the cave.
Well, I did not find the cave.
A month later, Kenny announced that he was once again going back to the canyon to attempt to find the cave. He even offered for people to join along, but no one else came. One person left an unnerving comment that read, "No, don't go back there. If you find that cave entrance, don't go in. If you do, you won't get out." This person probably wasn't being serious, but it's still eerie to read that, considering the events that followed. On November 10th, 2014, Kenny set out on a two-day hike to find the cave, but he never returned home. A month after Kenny went missing, his girlfriend left a comment on his last hiking video. She informed us that he never returned from the hike, and she called the police when he didn't return when he said he was supposed to. A search and rescue team was sent out, and they were only able to find a cell phone that he left behind near an entrance to an abandoned mineshaft. When they searched for Kenny inside the mineshaft, however, they were not able to find him. To this day, no one knows exactly what happened to Kenny, but there are three main theories that people have speculated on. One theory is that he died from natural causes in the canyon. Another is that he took this final trip to commit suicide. And finally, there's a theory that he was silenced by the government. Let's start with the first theory. This by itself already seems pretty plausible. I already mentioned before that spelunking and hiking has plenty of dangers as it is. But when you look at how few precautions Kenny actually took for these trips, it becomes clear that safety was not a huge concern of his. He rarely ever brought much food or water with him, just because he liked to make it more difficult for himself. He never brought a compass or a GPS, and the areas he hiked in weren't always the safest.
Because I didn't bring a whole lot of water, and I only got like one candy bar to get me through, but I like roughing it that way. I'm sure there's mountain lions out here, but there's, as you can see, there's no water out here. You gotta know which canyons to go down, otherwise you get lost up here. I don't bring a compass or anything.
He even talked about how on some of his hikes, his toenails would turn black and fall off. In his words, it would take him 3 days to recover from the abuse he put himself through. So it's definitely a possibility that something went wrong during his hike to find the cave, which subsequently led to his death. The next theory we have is that Kenny committed suicide. I was skeptical of this until I read the reasons why people believed it. I mentioned before that his girlfriend left some comments on his hiking video. We can confirm that this really is his girlfriend, because on her channel, she has videos of the two of them together. In one of her comments, she says she believed that Kenny committed suicide because he had been battling depression for many years. A little more than a year before his disappearance, he quit his job and tried to make a living selling inventions that he made. This didn't go well, which led to financial problems, which resulted in him getting even more depressed. The fact that his father also committed suicide when Kenny was younger didn't help. At one point, his girlfriend asked if he was going to pull a Robin Williams on her, and he told her that if he did it, no one would ever find him. This theory is supported by a few things. For one, we can see videos of Kenny showcasing his inventions for his Shark Tank audition videos on his channel, so that confirms that part of her story.
My name is Kenny Beek, and I invented the new improved toilet paper roll holder for the household.
Second, Kenny said that if he killed himself, no one would ever find him. Well, no one ever did find him. In addition, Kenny left for his trip without bringing his camera. If he was truly going out there to find the M cave, then surely he would have brought the camera. This would also explain why the search team was only able to find his phone. His girlfriend believes that he purposely left his phone behind so that his GPS couldn't be tracked. This seems reasonable to me, as I don't see any other reason why he would just leave his phone behind like that. All this put together really does make it seem like he may have gone out on this hike to end his life. The final theory is that Kenny was silenced by the government. Because the M cave was supposedly spotted near the Nellis Air Force Base, which is somewhat close to Area 51, some people believe that the M cave led to some type of secret underground military base. Some people theorize that Kenny found the cave, discovered something that he shouldn't have, and was then killed by the government so no one would find out. This would explain the vibrations that Kenny felt in his body when he first approached the cave. Many people speculate that the government can use infrasound to deter people from locations. Infrasound is pretty much just a low-frequency sound that can cause extreme uneasiness in people when they hear it. According to an article on PopSci.com, specific frequencies can make one's body vibrate with high enough power. Maybe the M cave was being protected by infrasound frequencies, and that is what deterred Kenny from going in the first time. If this is the case, then who knows what was being hidden in that cave? Whatever happened to Kenny, it's really sad that he had to go. No one may ever know what exactly happened to him. His body was never found, and no one has ever located the M cave either. One thing is for sure, Kenny definitely left behind a pretty big mystery. Thank you for watching, and I will see you on the flip side.